IBS and SIBO. What's the correlation and why is it so confusing? Watch this video for a clear explanation so that you can understand what they are and what you can do about it. For the most helpful information you'll find about IBS online, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell to be notified every Friday when I post a new video. If your head is spinning from all of the medical jargon and you still don't actually know what your diagnosis means, by the end of this video, you'll have an aha moment and a plan to help you get better. I'm Wendy Leung, holistic health and happiness coach, licensed acupuncturist, and powerhouse IBS conqueror, and I totally understand your diagnosis confusion. I help my clients understand their health and heal their guts for good, and now I'm sharing with you too. So your doctors have told you that you have IBS and you have SIBO, or you thought you had IBS, but now they're telling you it's actually SIBO. So what's the real answer? And more importantly, what can you do about it? In my last episode, I explained that the S in IBS is syndrome, referring to a collection of related digestive symptoms for which the cause is undefined. That means that medical science doesn't know what causes IBS, or do they? Now, what the heck is SIBO and how does it relate to IBS? Did your doctors explain to you what IBS and SIBO are? Let me know by dropping a yes or a no in the comments below. SIBO stands for small intestinal bacterial overgrowth. All sorts of different tiny organisms live in your gut. Bacteria, fungi, viruses, and that's totally normal. That's where they belong. There's an estimated 500 to 1,000 different types of bacteria in your gut alone, with most of them living in your small and large intestine. In a healthy gut, certain things keep the bacterial population in check, like bile, mucus, regular intestinal spasms, a valve that physically separates your small intestine from your large intestine, and eating a proper diet. But if these things stop working, that can lead to bacterial overgrowth, and if that happens in your small intestine, then that's SIBO. SIBO used to be hard to detect because it involved a very finicky culture sample testing, but now doctors are using a breath test, which is why you're starting to hear more about it. Western medicine still has a huge question mark when it comes to IBS and what causes it, but there's a debate that in some cases, not all, that SIBO might be the underlying cause. The symptoms are very similar. Extreme bloating, diarrhea or constipation, pain, smelly gas. So it makes sense for your doctors to be adding a SIBO test to the already long list of diagnostic tests that they're putting you through. Now, what does that mean for those of you who are struggling with these symptoms? If you've been diagnosed with SIBO, doctors will put you on a course of antibiotics to try and get the bacteria under control. Studies show that this works for some people, but not for others, because the drugs only treat the overgrowth, not the reason behind it, which means that it could just reoccur. Also, long-term use of antibiotics are notoriously known for weakening your gut, so it could cause even more digestive issues long-term. From a traditional Chinese medicine perspective, or TCM for short, whether you have IBS or you have SIBO, we recognize that your digestive system is out of balance. We don't actually need to know if there's a bacterial overgrowth or not to be able to help you recover from your painful gut symptoms. The bottom line is, your gut is too weak to perform its regular functions and it needs to be strengthened and supported for it to be able to start doing its job properly again. And if you want to learn more about how to do that, I've got a free online class that'll teach you exactly that. The link is in the description box below. So to recap, IBS and SIBO are two Western medical diagnoses that share very similar symptoms, and they may or may not be related. The jury's still out. TCM sees all of these symptoms as a weak digestive system, and we strengthen it with the right eating habits and a gut-supporting diet. Online class in the description box below. If you want a little more time to digest this information, sign up for my newsletter and I will send you a Gut Digest 101 booklet where I explain and summarize all of these things in an easy to understand way. The link is in the description box below. Also, come join a tribe of people just like you in my Facebook community of Powerful Women Conquering IBS, where I share even more tips on how to kickstart your IBS journey to health. If you like this video, let me know by liking it below, post a comment with the word helpful, and let me know what your biggest aha moment was. And share this video with your fellow IBS conquerors because I want to spread the word that IBS is not a forever thing and I can help you guys beat this together. I have so much more to share with you about all things IBS, so make sure that you're subscribed to my channel and that you hit that bell so that you're notified every single Friday when I post a new video.